In this tutorial, we will perform a very common transformation, taking non-spatial data in a CSV file and writing it out to a spatial format, in this case, map info tab. To create the desired output, we will be using a number of the top 25 FME transformers. Our CSV file lists cell phone signal measurements at various locations in the city of Vancouver. In the table view, we see that we have longitude, latitude, station ID, power, quality, code, and a timestamp. What we want is this. The timestamp has to be in a different format, and a quality of signal will be derived from power and quality. We will also remove records that are missing data or do not have a particular set of code values. Let's create the workspace by opening FME Workbench. We will select Generate Workspace in the Getting Started window. We will select the source CSV file. And be sure to set the X coordinate and Y coordinate. We will set the coordinate system as LL84, longitude, latitude. The destination format is map info tab. Click OK to create the workspace. Select the output feature type and hit Enter to open the Feature Type Properties dialog. In the General tab, set the table name to Quality of Signal. Then click on the User Attributes tab and set the attribute definition to Automatic. This enables automatic attribute definitions depending on Canvas connections. Then click OK. Go ahead and save your workspace. Right-click on the output and choose Inspect to open the newly created Map Info tab file in the FME Data Inspector. There is some cleanup that we will want to do with our source CSV data. We will need to remove features that are missing data, remove duplicate data points, change the date to proper format, derive a quality of signal attribute from code, power, and quality, and finally, use quality of signal to set a feature color. The first step is to remove the features that are missing attribute values. The missing values could be empty, null, or missing. To simplify the tester settings, we will cast all three options to be missing by using the null attribute mapper. Add a null attribute mapper first and hit Enter to open the null attribute mapper parameters. For selected attributes, we will choose the attributes we are interested in: code, latitude, longitude, power, and quality. For if attribute value is, select all options: empty, missing, and null. We will map to missing. Now that we have mapped empty, missing, and null attributes to be missing, we can test on that and filter out those features. Add a tester and hit Enter to open the parameters. We will test if the attribute is missing for code or power or quality. Because we are interested in the features that are not missing these attributes, we will negate the tests. Negate changes the test to be attribute is not missing. Next, we want to make sure that no latitude or longitude values are missing. Add another tester and test for attribute is missing for latitude or longitude. We will negate the tests because we are interested in the features that are not missing these attributes. The next step is to remove features that are duplicate data points. Add a duplicate remover and hit Enter to open the parameters. The key attributes are longitude and latitude. Next, the formatting of the record t-stamp is incorrect for our output. We will add a date formatter to correct it. Hit Enter to open the parameters and set the source date format to automatic detection and the destination date format to be %D/%M/%Y. %D is the day number, %M is the month number, and %Y is the four-digit year. Details about what the different variables are can be found in the help. The code attribute actually consists of two separate attributes, code tag and code value. Code tag is the first three letters of code. Code value is the remaining numbers. We won't be using code value here, but we will be testing for a code tag of ABC or ABD. Those are the only code values we want in the output. A regular expression can be used to split code into code tag and code value. Add a string searcher and hit Enter to open the parameters. The regular expression will find the first three letters of the code. This means that code tag is the matched result attribute. The remainder of the code will be code value. We will add a string replacer and set the text to match to be AZ, 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 and then set the replacement text to be blank. This will delete the first three letters of the code, leaving us with code value. We can then use an attribute renamer to rename code to code value. We can now filter out any data points that do not have a code tag of ABC or ABD by using an attribute filter. Add an attribute filter and hit Enter to open the parameters. Filter on code tag and add ABC and ABD to the possible attribute values. Then connect the attribute output ports. Next, we want to divide the data points by power, very high, high, and medium. Add an attribute range filter. Set the source attribute to power, and then enter the very high, high, and medium ranges. Different power ranges have different levels of acceptable quality. We will add tester transformers to filter out features that are outside allowable quality ranges. The other two testers are set up in a similar fashion. Now that we have filtered the power and quality, we can set a quality of signal by using attribute creators. Next, we will set the color of the output features based on the quality of signal using an attribute value mapper. Our source attribute is quality of signal. Our destination attribute is FME color. And then we can map best, reasonable, and worst to desired RGB values. FME color is an FME attribute which represents the red, green, and blue intensities of a feature, with values between 0 and 1. Finally, we will add an attribute keeper so that our output only has the attributes that we are interested in. Now we can run our translation with full inspection to see how many features are filtered out, and then inspect our final output. Zooming in shows us that many of our signal qualities are best represented by the black points, or reasonable, represented by the dark blue points.